Welcome to Vespers at La Sierra University Church. The musicians have come. They're here to lift up the trumpet. And we are here coming to find rest and inspiration at the end of a long week. We are so grateful for Dr. Elvin Rodriguez and the La Sierra University Music Department for helping us put together this Vespers for tonight. And the musicians have put together an introductory paragraph for the program tonight. Great Hymns of Yesterday, Today, and Tomorrow is a program of adoration to our God. Adoration is a response to the mercy, providence, and blessings that God has given each one of us during this week. Welcome to this sacred concert, and the instrumentalists invite us to join them in the praise of the one who is our creator, sustainer, and savior. Let us pray together. Dear God, we are so grateful for this day of life. Thank you that we've come to the end of another week. And tonight, we seek for an awareness of your presence with us as we enjoy the inspiration of the beautiful music. We ask it all in your name. Amen.
God is the creator of music, the first musician in the universe. Ellen G. White, in the book The Voice in Speech and Song, on page 407, says, "Music is a precious gift of God, designed to uplift the thoughts to high and noble themes, to inspire and elevate the soul. It is God who gave us the gift of painting our time with sound, and we use it now to glorify him. Together, we can say with the psalmist of Psalm 115, 'Not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to your name give glory, for the sake of your steadfast love and your faithfulness.'"
Thank you.
David's prayer. David praised the Lord in the presence of the whole assembly, saying, "Praise be to you, Lord, the God of our father Israel, from everlasting to everlasting. Yours, Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the majesty and the splendor, for everything in heaven and earth is yours. Yours, Lord, is the kingdom. You are exalted as head over all. Now, our God, we give you thanks and praise your glorious name." 1 Chronicles 29, 10 to 11 and 13. The Lord is my strength and my defense. He has become my salvation. He is my God, and I will praise him. My Father's God, and I will exalt him. Exodus 15, verse 2. I will give thanks to the Lord because of his righteousness. I will sing the praises of the name of the Lord Most High. Psalms 7, 17. We bow down to you, our Maker and our Savior, acknowledging your greatness and holiness and accepting that we are your creation. We submit to your sovereignty, responding to your majestic presence with reverence and respect. Help us to live a life of faith, of obedience, and of surrender to you, and to put you first in what we say, do, and think. Help us to obey your commandments and minister to those in need. May we always remember to place our trust in you, for only from you do we encounter peace that passes all understanding. Thank you. 'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take him at his word, just to rest upon his promise, just to know, thus saith the Lord. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I've proved him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more. Louisa M.R. Steed. Praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Praise him for his acts of power. Praise him for his surpassing greatness. Praise him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise him with the harp and lyre. Praise him with timbrel and dancing. Praise him with the strings and pipe. Praise him with the clash of cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Psalm 150.
This week, when we were planning to put together this program and thinking about what a good title for this program would be, we were thinking of great hymns of yesterday, today, and tomorrow. And this is why. Because there is a plague of skepticism that is devouring our world. Who can we trust is the question. The people we admire most, they fall. They stumble, the leaders make mistakes, friends drop out, even the most sincere people disappoint us and fail in their best intentions. Where to put our feet and know that we will be not disappointed? A few days ago, I was speaking with a woman that was facing the battle against cancer for the third time in her 60s. But now she's alone because the man who promised her eternal love led her to never return. Pandemics, divorces, division, conflicts are what our eyes see. Where should we go? Sometimes in the depths of us, it is difficult to trust again in the same way that the difficulties and calamities that are so common in this life break our security and discourage us. But in the book of life, Moses wrote, "He is our rock. His works are perfect, and all his ways are just. A faithful God who does not wrong, upright and just is he. He is a sure base from which we can depend. We can trust in his faithfulness. And that person is Jesus Christ, who is the same yesterday, today, and forever and ever."
And we thank you, Lord, for your love. In Christ Jesus, you have loved us with an eternal love without end. He saved us with his blood. He forgave us. He rescued us. In a world of hatred, violence, and evil, we only find in you the true dimension of love. We understand that this is truly our Father's world.
Let us close with prayer. Dear God, we are grateful for the wonderful music that we have been able to enjoy this evening. Thank you for giving such amazing talents to these musicians. Thank you, God, that we can use the words and the thoughts inspired by these great hymns to strengthen our trust in you. We pray for our loved ones, our friends and family who may not be well. We ask for healing and peace in their lives and in our world. And as we go into this weekend, we pray, God, that the feeling of joy and inspiration that we receive from the music tonight will carry us in a positive spirit and a good attitude for the rest of the weekend. Thank you so much for this wonderful program this evening. We pray in your name. Amen. Thank you, everyone, for joining us for our musical vespers tonight. We are very grateful to our musicians, and let's give them another round of applause. Have a wonderful night, everyone. Be well.